Hey guys, Brown Brownie here. I'm editing the Enslaved series. The episode you're about to see, I was editing it. This is actually part 5. For some reason, the video for part 4 got corrupted and it won't play anywhere and I can't convert it to any format, and Premiere Pro doesn't let me open it. So I lost an episode of Enslaved. It didn't matter. All we did was jump around and throw the lady across a couple minefields, probably. But yeah, that's it. You get part 5. Part 4 got lost. I'm sorry. I'll try to not let it happen again. I don't know what's happening with my files lately. Some of them got misplaced for the Episcope series, and then some of them got corrupted for the Enslaved. Hopefully this is just the one. Other than that, everything's fine. Please enjoy the episode. Sorry if the plot doesn't make sense, but this is Enslaved. It doesn't make any more sense anyway. So just here, just go back to the episode. I've rambled on for too long. Thank you.
1, 2, 3.
Beep.
Okay.
Yeah, that synced. That sank.
It is synced.
Like, that was a pretty good sinking.
That was pretty good sinking.
Like, straight Titanic status.
Alright, man. Shit. How can I top that introduction?
Reloading. Chapter 3, The Metal Tower.
Chapter 3, The Metal Tower.
So, the highlight of Animazement, I went to a badly dumped hentai panel.
We're getting closer.
And it was basically a room filled of, like, 40 people. All watching actual, like, hardcore hentai.
What the fuck,
in
man?
In the most messed up sense. All like, Mystery Science Theater 3000 version. And then all doing sex noises in order to get a tentacle.
Alright, first of all, welcome back to Press to Play. Second of all, what the fuck did you... What were you doing at a fucking hentai panel?
It's anime. I mean, I could have done the speed dating, or I could have went to bad hentai dubs. Which would you have chosen?
Probably, you can probably do both at the same time, in the same fucking panel, you know? Like, they're all watching hentai while speed dating, and like, at some point they just speed fuck.
Listen, this is a child-appropriate show.
Is it?
You motherfucking hen whore.
Hen whore?
Alright.
Anyway, well, I already said welcome back. We're playing Enslaved again. Fucking getting this game over with.
Dude, getting this game over with is not a bad thing. I was watching the edits for the first episode, which you guys hopefully enjoyed a little bit. But the first round of edits made me chuckle a little bit. I come back from con life.
Yeah, this is a week after we recorded the first few episodes.
Yeah, and I was just like, "Yo, Brian, I'm back from conning," and he shows me that. And I'm like, yeah.
Fucking, alright, I gotta say that as far as, like, 90s style emo music goes, Falling Through April, really fucking good band.
Yeah.
They sound really damn good, and I'm sorry that I'm making fun of their music by putting them like that. But, they're really fucking good, and they're from Charlotte, too.
Yeah.
What the hell? They got a free show at NASCAR on June 4th.
Just free show at a NASCAR?
Yeah, no, a NASCAR Hall of Fame.
Good. At a NASCAR.
Yeah, at a NASCAR. They just sit on top of a car and they just drive around the fucking speedway. And then hopefully not one of them doesn't die.
Yeah. Did I kill her? Did I accidentally kill her because of sensor?
No, you can press L2 to find her.
Oh, so, yeah, I forgot we had that
she's thing. Right over. Look at her, just like, oh, I guess I'll just fucking sit here because I can't jump because I'm not a fucking monkey.
Okay.
I think you gotta throw her. Throw if you can jump back. There we go. I love the fact that you can just fucking throw her. Is it zero again?
Alright, come on,
I don't
come
remember.
Shock her.
Yep.
Oh!
Help, I'm slipping!
Oh, God. You should have just let her
I
slip.
I know. But then we have to go through another load screen.
Fucking step on her toe.
You see, the problem with this game is we'd have to go through loading, and I don't want to do that.
Yeah, that's actually pretty goddamn annoying. The load screens in this game are like Bloodborne level. By the way, I'm sad that we don't have a PS4 to play fucking Bloodborne. I really want to play that game.
In time.
In time it'll happen.
See, why did I have to get her permission to lift this car?
That's fucking...
Like, I was already able to lift this car. Why do we need her during this whole journey?
We don't. There's we like don't. Not a we don't. Spot. We could have done this game without her at all. Or like, we didn't need her. We didn't fucking need her.
Bam!
All we do is like throwing her across shit, and then like maybe at the end of it, she'll die.
Pretty much. It was like, I was sad that I didn't see any of this cosplay, though. I really was hoping Animazement would have the one enslaved cosplay.
This game wasn't very popular, yeah. I think it was like...
I mean, it's gotten some acclaim, at least. Some fun.
Yeah. I mean, I'll give it something, like, it looks gorgeous.
Yeah. It's weird going back from Ape Escape, which is just like a really fun, like, very precise controls, super fun. To this.
You want me to be honest with you?
Yeah.
When you left the next day, when you left from recording last time?
Yep.
I immediately came back in and then played Ape Escape again.
I told you how good that was.
I didn't save, I just started from the beginning and I just played Ape Escape again for like an hour. Such a fun fucking game. It's really stupid how fun it is. Oh, cutscene. What the fuck? Like, I'm glad you share my fucking emotions. Oh, what?
It's a guy.
What?
On the computer, typing. That was the stupidest vision ever. It was just a vision of a normal work day.
It's really dramatic. It was a student, too. It wasn't anyone interesting.
Oh, no. I'm watching this guy. Do a TPS report.
By the way, I don't know if you...
And then, go beat up a fax machine with his two other friends in the back of a field.
What movie was that?
Dude, Office Space.
Office Space.
Welcome to Movie Monday, where we quote movies and make puns. It's also Pun Day Monday, because I'm not a fan of your fan!
You could have just told me to put in an air horn effect. I would have gladly done that. And so now I gotta edit your fucking bullshit sound effect.
Don't you love having me around? Hey, Gert. Listen. You gotta stop being so crackled.
Okay, listen. I wanna point out, first of all.
Yeah?
We didn't hear it. You keep going. Keep fucking moving. We didn't hear it when we were playing, because our volume is, like, down.
Yeah.
When we play, so we don't actually hear the voice acting. The voice acting for fucking Monkey.
Yeah.
Is so bad.
Really?
So bad. I'll show you later in an episode, but yeah, it is awful.
Well, I'll rewatch the first three episodes and then we'll...
Like...
Oh, God.
Like, stop you're it. Gonna get shot. He looks stop like this.
Hey. Listen.
Do the decoy bullshit. There we go. No, but the voice acting for Monkey is seriously, like... Not even, like, cheesy bad, it's just fucking bad.
Like, oh, it's just like they ran out of...
His voice does not match the design whatsoever. It's he sounds like a lawyer's son. And I don't like it. Okay. Fully charged. Alright, shut up. See?
Distracting!
He sounds like if Sonic the Hedgehog was going through puberty. That's what he sounds like.
Okay, this is still a better game than Sonic Boom, though. In terms
dude,
of both controls
I can make acting. A better game than Sonic Boom. And I have no programming experience whatsoever.
Oh, God!
I actually feel bad for the quality assurance people from Sonic Boom. Because they knew about these problems and they wanted to fix them, but obviously the game was pushed out really early. Yeah. So they had no choice but to suck it up and get called shit.
I mean, that's what happened with Sonic 06 as well.
Yeah, do you think they learned their fucking lesson? You would think they have. They don't.
And they made Sonic Generations, which was pretty decent. I mean, it may have been a different Sonic dev team. I'm not too aware of my Sonics.
Yeah, like you said in the first episode, oh, this is developed by fucking Capcom. Ninja Theory and Namco.
Listen. We bought. You know how many games I bought of Capcom that day.
That's true.
Like, if you look at our library, it was like all Capcom. It was a very safe assumption. And then the one game I have that I bought for this Let's Play.
It's not... Yeah. You're gonna get fucking
God.
Shot.
Come on, come on. Scotty.
Just. Scotty?
Yeah.
What was I saying?
Motherfucker.
You gotta shoot him.
I can't drop down.
No, you gotta shoot him.
Oh, I have to shoot him.
Yeah, I don't remember how to do it, but you gotta shoot him. Not like that. That's just screaming.
That's just screaming.
There we go.
Oh.
God, ugh.
Alright.
Ugh. Distracted! Just so fucking...
Call of Duty, motherfucker!
You just fall down. Yep.
Boom!
That took three bullets.
I am MLJ zone.
Why doesn't he just do that?
I'm MLJ.
Dude, you gotta, you can't get far.
Oh,
you gotta call
come
her.
Come on.
You gotta call her.
I know.
Because otherwise your hair goes like, oh no, I can't be alone too long. Then just press L1, she'll come back to you. Fucking...
What is that casual walk?
Just go get to the ladder and walk it down.
This game makes me feel things.
Top of the morning to ya.
Top of the morning to ya, laddie.
I'm gonna throw down this ladder and hopefully it skewers you, bitch.
Jesus. Hopefully it skewers you. Oh. Oh, man.
What did...
So, okay, let's just ignore what's going on screen and let's talk about Animazement for a while.
Okay.
How was Animazement?
It was pretty good. Pretty good. I saw Evan that we went to Magfest with there.
Oh, shit. Brian, put up a picture of Evan.
I'll put up the picture of Evan from Magfest. I was stealing my cowboy hat. Because I know he definitely wants that spread across
no,
the
No, no. Brian, put a picture of Evan with the hentai car. I don't think
I can get you. Dude, he has a repeat picture of the hentai car. The hentai car came back for...
Really?
Yeah. Dude. That was.
Wait,
like...
what picture with a cowboy hat?
Oh, yeah, I have a picture with him from when I went to old Magoo Fest. Oh, sorry, for when I went to Animazement. I ran into him, made him wear my cowboy hat and sunglasses.
Oh, you guys didn't go together? You just ran into each other?
Yeah, no, I just ran into him.
That's fucking cool.
It was a random encounter.
That's interesting. So he just stole your fucking cap. Ay, this bitch with the hacking.
Yeah, but it was a lot of play. Like we've mentioned before, I work at a children's trading card game. Company that does also manga and anime stuff. So we were there and had some fun, did some demos, and went to bad hentai dubs. I also saw two other...
Oh, wait. There were dubs?
Yes.
Like, people were voicing over the hentai?
Well, that was part of it at the very, very end. It was that you had to make your best hentai voice in order to win a tentacle.
A tentacle?
And the winner was this girl who could speak fluent Japanese.
But the, of course she fucking won.
Yeah.
So, did she say senpai at any point?
I believe so. It was something. No, we're not going to put up a clip from there.
No, God no.
From the panel.
That'll get my channel banned from YouTube.
Even though it's probably on YouTube. Just look up Animazement 2015.
Hentai panel.
Hentai panel. Or it's actually called Did You Hear That? Was the name of the panel.
Did you hear that? Yeah, aren't there kids at that fucking place?
Yeah, but you had an 18-plus wristband to go to that one.
You know, at least they had some fucking control over that.
Yeah, I mean...
What time was it? Was it, like, late at night?
Yeah, it was, like, at 1 a.m.
Oh, that makes sense. Okay. I'm just picturing, like, a bunch of, like, hentai geeks.
Right?
Fucking...
No, it was... The weirdest one was the girl who had a samurai sword and yeah...
And the sandwich, did you just fucking fade out on that story? What happened?
I'm not going into this anymore.
Did she use a sword as a dildo-ish item?
Sure, let's not
go into. Let's not get me banned. You
because we'll end up like that.
You died. It's my turn now. Let me see how this shit is going. So fucking anime conventions are a weird place.
The other weird ones I went to see Rookies is Punked. They're a Japanese J-punk band. They're really cool.
Sweet.
They do a lot of anime themes. Also went to a taiko demonstration. So I did a lot of music stuff at the anime
taiko?
Convention.
What's
yeah,
taiko?
Like the big old taiko drum. Remember when me and Evan were playing
taiko
drum master?
Oh, the little yeah.
But this is like actual real taiko drums.
Is it? Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Also
awesome.
Shout out to Taiko Drum Master because. Brownie knows how much me and Evan are obsessed with that
Listen,
game.
We were at fucking MAGFest, and these assholes made us wait an hour and a half so they could play fucking Taiko Drum Machine for like three turns. And me and Trey were just standing behind them, holding their bags, going like, I'm gonna kill these guys. Just all of them. Just all of them.
It was worth it.
At the same time. And no, it absolutely was. It looked like a fun-ass game.
Other cool panels that were there, Frieza versus Frieza.
Freezer.
It was the voice actress for Frieza and the voice actor, the Japanese voice actor for Frieza.
Okay.
Doing lines for the new movie.
Oh, the return, the resurrection of whatever.
Of Frieza.
Of Frieza, there we go. Well, why, I knew that name. Why did I say that? How are you doing, buddy? Get over here.
Dude, he has a shield. And then a shield, dude. Shield.
There we go. I took him down.
And probably the highlight was that Ricky's just punked. There's this... Yeah, that pretty much
happened. Shit, that's awesome.
Oh my gosh.
Get over here.
This is Gears of Woe.
Gears of Woe.
Dang.
Dom!
Dude. What? Dom's just funny because you get the Ben 10 voice actor to play the character.
Is that the Ben 10 voice actor?
It's one of the voices that Ben 10 does.
Oh, sure.
Like one of the aliens that he transforms into.
I didn't know that. That's awesome.
It was just like this big old cat guy who's just a delusion. I forget his name right now.
This bitch, can you... I don't know what the...
Hey, Brownie, put up a picture of, the Ben 10 guy and then say, Matt, you're an idiot, this is his name, and then insert name in parentheses.
I will do that by the fucking letter. I hope you know that. I'm gonna get it killed. I'm gonna get that bitch killed.
By the way, you need the ladder.
Yeah, thank you.
Even though that was not obvious.
Let me just...
You have to throw her up there so she can put the ladder down for you this time.
God damn it. Get over here. But I gotta kill that fucking guy. Hey, buddy. I missed. I am not okay. I am not okay. Yeah. I just need you to hold me. Alright.
Anything else for both of us? I made some pictures, some videos, and, I know I'm, like, the most vaguest person.
Yeah, you really
just
are.
Just because I just got back from An Amazement, like, less than...
You should remember everything that fucking happened.
Less than, like, 12 hours.
You should be able to tell me about the girl that shit herself in the middle of the lobby after partying too hard.
Right? It's... I literally drove up here from An Amazement recording.
What the fuck, man? You didn't tell me that. Yeah. Now I feel bad.
No, don't feel bad.
I'm gonna fall. Okay. This is like Uncharted.
This is like Sleepy Rossi recovering from con, like, everything. And I'm like, oh no, they used the chair.
Not only that, they used the Uncharted animation where he falls and just, like, hits himself in the middle of the chest and goes like, bleh!
There's a lot of this game.
That's Uncharted?
Just that may just be a reskinned Uncharted.
Let me see, can I shoot this? Nope. Oh, thank you. Did it work or did it not work? Ammo!
It's not.
No, I am not okay. I am not okay.
Go.
Jesus.
Remember, you're supposed to...
I'm supposed to do the decoy bullshit. God. Fucking Christ, that was scary.
You have less than a bee's dick worth of health left.
Bee's dick? Do I have to shoot it?
No, I think she has to unlock it, meaning that you have to distract. You have to...
I have to shoot the fucking thing.
Yes. But the probably biggest highlight for my own personal one was Rookies is Punked.
Mm-hmm.
They're a band that doesn't really speak English too much.
Yeah?
They were kind of struggling with... Yeah, dude, just...
I can't jump over there, Maddie.
Dude,
I can't...
There's a whole thing right over there.
I did not see that, and I'm gonna die. All right.
Rookies is
3 minutes till the end of the episode.
Yeah, there's four lads that could barely speak English. And the one... They all had, like, a song where they were trying to do it. Like, one did, Feel Good Tonight's Gonna Be a Good Night.
Oh,
they're very broken English.
That's
but
awesome.
The drummer... Couldn't speak almost a lick of English. She's like, I got one song for you guys. And he just goes, let it go. Let it go. Don't be back in the
mirror. That's fucking adorable.
I know. And it's not me being like,
racist,
offensive. No. It was just, that was what he did.
Listen, that's
just so...
that's just an Uncharted animation.
Yeah.
I played through Uncharted 1 and 3 and I saw that animation fucking 50 times throughout that game. There's no way that's
the
not.
The guy was just so clever in that he did that. And I was just like, you know what? You're a good guy. You're a good band.
That's awesome, dude. The fact that they just fucking sang Let It Go. Now I feel racist.
Yeah, you're the one that said Reddit. Thank you, Reddit.
Fucking Reddit. Oh, that's what you're supposed to do. Okay, well, sorry I wasn't smart enough to figure out that bit.
Because you're not like, me.
The fucking mechanic.
I'm just the natural monkey. Oh.
Just not so charging.
Johnny Bravo would be proud for me to do the monkey.
Johnny Bravo. Dude, it's been a while since I heard about fucking Johnny Bravo.
Performer takedown.
You're just gonna break a turret's neck. You're mine now. That makes no sense. If you fuck up the turning mechanism, you just fuck up the turret. Shouldn't be able to use it after that. What?
Turrets are living. You gotta snap their neck. When you see technology, you must first snap its neck. This guy's literally the post-apocalyptic Bear Grylls. That's exactly what it is. But first, I'm gonna snap his neck.
Today, I'm gonna teach you how to survive in New York City.
But first, we must snap some turrets. Alright, everyone. On the next episode, Bear Grylls comes back. And listen, on the next episode, we snap some turrets.
Oh, fucking Bear Grylls.
Have a bagel baked die.
I'm gonna fucking end the episode now.
Fucking. Perform takedown.